Hey guys, Andrew here from Firerocker Studios, and today we are in the brand new Minecraft 1.10 snapshot 16W21A. Now this snapshot is pretty much just fixing a ton of bugs, but yeah, so I'm not going to be able to show you guys too much of the cool new features, since this is more of a technical snapshot than an actual feature snapshot. What I will do is show you guys an epic one command block contraption made by the awesome user called EnergyXXER, links to this in the description down below. So you can see behind me, there's a cute little penguin. You guys can spawn this in your world. It's super simple. I'll show you how in just a second. And the bears are currently huddling him like crazy. But yeah, let me know in the comment section down below, what do you guys think about the 1.10 update so far with all the new features? I'm gonna go over everything real quick as well, so you guys can see everything and you guys are up to date, as well as show you the one command contraption, which is super cool. All you need to do is copy one command into the world. And yeah, now before I get started with all that, I want you guys to let me know in the comment section down below, what do you think about 1.10? As you can see, the comments that are currently on your screen right now are from the last video. I'm going to be picking about 5 winners, or not 5 winners, but about 5 people from the comment section of this video to be featured in my next video. So make sure to leave a comment, let me know what you guys think. And yeah, real quick, before I get started with showing you guys the penguins, I also want to say thanks to our awesome sponsors at GetGifts. We're able to do giveaways every single week. If you guys don't know what GetGifts is, it's an awesome app that makes it so you can actually win really cool prizes like Xbox Live gift codes or gift cards in general for stores that you may like. So if you guys want to check them out, links to them is in the description down below. I'm actually making a video this weekend talking a little bit more about them, so make sure to check that out. But yeah, check out Get Gifts, guys, if you guys want to get some free gift cards and other really neat stuff like that. But on to the penguin. So here is the penguin. I have him right next to the bears because, well, it just makes sense. Well, go ahead and paste him over here. So how this basically works is it's using a couple of commands. I don't really know how they fully work, but if you guys are interested in seeing the more technical side to this, go to the link in the description down below, because I actually have the page of the user there. Now, he has a couple of other really cool stuff. I really want to show off the submarine that he made as well. Now, this works, I believe, in also 1.9, but I'm currently using it in 1.10 snapshot 16W21A. Now, the command is actually pretty simple to do if you don't know what you're doing, because all you have to do is paste one command block. Now, all you have to do is do the simple command, which is slash give space at player or at p space command underscore block. That'll give you a command block like this, where then you will place it down, you will right click, you will paste the command from your little mouse thing. You're gonna right click the command first on the website, you're gonna paste it on here, and I'll show you how to do that. You just hold Control V and then it pastes it. You select needs redstone and then you hit done. I'm not gonna do that because I already did it, but once you have done that, it'll basically generate these command blocks, and then all you have to do is right click the sign, not the button, just the sign, and then it'll actually give you this egg, and then it's called spawn penguin. So I'll go ahead and spawn a couple of these bad boys so you can see how they look. They're pretty cool. There's animation to their little wings. They turn around. If you hit them, they get damaged like that, and they actually get a different texture, as you can see, and that's what happens when you kill them. I feel kind of bad now. But yeah, also if they're right next to each other, they both sometimes take the equal damage. But yeah, they're pretty cool, and they're really cute to add to your world since they don't really disrupt much of anything. Now, they do require you use this resource pack, which also does is change about, I think, only 2 things in the game. But yeah, before I continue talking about that, let's do something real quick. Slash weather space clear space 99999, because I think it is currently raining, or I'm not sure, it looked kind of cloudy. But I'll go over all the other really cool stuff that came out in the snapshot last week. For example, we have all these new blocks. You've got the magma block. If you step on it, it gives you damage. Of course, now I'm currently in creative, so it's not going to give me damage. So if I go ahead and do slash game mode 0, you can see it does give me damage as I step on it, but if I shift walk on it, I'll actually be fine. So let me do slash game mode 1 again so I don't die. We also have these new blocks to craft yourself. I forgot what this is called. Let me go into my inventory right over here. Actually, I can just go right in here. Okay, so we have the magma block, which you get from the nether. You also have this brand new block. Let me go into the new block so I can actually show you what it's called. I forgot its name. Scrolling. Okay, so nether wart block. Nether wart block, you basically put 9 nether warts into a crafting table and it'll give you that. And if you want to make red nether brick, it's actually pretty simple. You just get 2 bricks and 2 nether warts, and you put nether wart, red brick, and it'll give you a red brick nether word, a red nether word block, just like that. Now we also have bones, which they're pretty cool. They're basically, well, I have some right over here. They basically come in fossils, and you find them randomly in the game like this. So you gotta excavate them, so they're gonna be buried underground. I don't know how deep, but you can usually find a skull or a body or both. So go look for them, guys. They're pretty cool. And if you have one of these, you put it in the crafting table, you actually get 9 bone meal back. And if you put 9 bone meal in the crafting table, you get 1 block. So that's pretty cool. Of course, we have polar bears, as you can see. They come in adult forms and in babies. The adults are neutral, so if you hit them, they'll attack you. But if you don't, they won't do anything. Now, of course, I'm in creative mode, so they're not attacking me. But I'm just showing you how this one works over here. Their health is pretty strong, so be careful. They, of course, drop fish when you spawn them in, or when you kill them, I'm gonna say. So let me actually go ahead and actually put... Let me put a cub. Now, of course, if you right-click on the bear while spawning it in, it actually will spawn a cub for you. So the moms are hostile, so if you ever see an adult bear with a cub, definitely stay away from it because it will attack you for no reason, just because that's how mothers are. But yeah, we also have a brand new structure block, which is called Structure Void, which you have to spawn in. And we have 2 new hostile mobs. They are the Stray and the Husk, which I'll go ahead and show you how they look in just a second. Let me put these down. So, this is the Stray, and this is the Husk. And you can find the Husk in the drier areas, and I believe the Stray spawns in cold biomes. So, there you go. They drop really cool stuff. I'll go ahead and kill this one so you guys can see. So, yep, I got a special arrow, and from the Husk, I believe... I don't know if you actually get anything special from the Husk, but at least we get something cool from the Stray, and that is an arrow of slowness, so that's pretty neat. And yeah, we can also now spawn in the skeleton and the zombie horses just by spawning them in with their eggs. They actually have an egg now. Before, you had to use the command, so I guess that's pretty cool. But that basically wraps it up for the main part about this. I go more in depth in my actual review, guys. So if you guys want to see my full review that I did last week on the snapshot, definitely check it out. But here are the penguins. Hopefully you enjoyed this little video, this one command block tutorial. Definitely check out EnergyXXER because he made these and he is actually awesome. He's a new YouTuber. He only has 500 subscribers right now. So check it out. These contraptions are pretty cool. And we also have a new roleplay series coming out very soon, guys. So definitely stay tuned to my channel. We've been working really hard, me and Reader and Ryan. So it's gonna be fun, but that's pretty much it for this video. Hopefully you enjoyed. If you want to add yourself some cute little penguins to your world, then this is a command. Super simple. That's pretty much it for me. Like always, I'm Andrew from FireRocker Studios. You guys are rockers. Check out the description. Hit that button for subscription. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. You could be featured in next week's video. And I will see you tomorrow. Bye!